Hello, everyone. Michael Vaughn here with the Canadian University Report from the Globe and Mail. Now, if you don't know this publication, I can tell you it's a very good resource for students choosing a university or a college in Canada, or, of course, their parents. They're interested in these decisions, too. This is not an evaluation on some ranking system, some mathematical formula. This is based on interviews with more than 30,000 students in Canadian universities and colleges right now. I think it's worth looking at. Well, anyway, tonight we are going to focus on engineering and science, and we have just an excellent roster of guests. And let me begin by introducing you to our first two. Sitting over here on my left is David Wilkinson. And David is the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering at McMaster University in Hamilton. Hello, David.
Hello.
Dr. Ian Mann, next door, is Professor of Physics. He's the Canada Research Chair, Science in Space Physics, at the University of Alberta. Hello, Ian.
Hello.
Well, space is always exciting. Everyone loves to talk about space. But if you want to be a big-time engineer in the space field, you've got MIT, you've got Caltech, and I would think that's about it.
That's a common perception, I think, amongst people, prospective students maybe, and parents. But, you know, Canadian universities have a very powerful reputation in a number of niche areas applied to space, partnerships with the main space agencies. Canadian Space Agency has a very active program, and there's linkages, for example, at the University of Alberta, if I take examples from my own area, with NASA, with the European Space Agency. So activities in niche areas at the core of fantastically exciting research in space.
Is that the key, to be connected up with the major agencies?
I think that there's a number of keys. So being part of the global endeavor at the forefront of research areas internationally, that's critical. I think innovation and the ability to bring something powerful to the table, something new that perhaps might not be able to be provided from within the, for example, the space agencies themselves. What can Canadian universities and Canadian innovation bring to the table? We have a lot to offer. That's recognized internationally that we have a lot to offer, and that's indeed why these partnerships with NASA, European Space Agency, and other world space agencies come to the fore.
Engineering faculties seem to be into partnerships more than certainly when I was a student there. And I know Mac has tied in with some major industrial partners as well.
Partnerships are absolutely vital to everything that we do, particularly at the research end of the spectrum, but also in terms of our undergraduate education. Take, for example, McMaster's strength in automotive research and technology. We've been partnered with General Motors for 20 years now. We have partnerships with all of the other major OEMs, the major parts suppliers, and they support a wide range of activities throughout the university. We've just been able to, as a consequence of that, bring to McMaster the only Canada Excellence Research Chair in the automotive sector. Ali Ahmadi is coming from the United States next year, and he will be not only bringing his expertise in electrification of vehicles to McMaster, he's actually already revolutionizing the way we teach power engineering within the university and integrating that throughout the program from the graduate level down to the undergraduate level, and is already starting to develop new initiatives around our various vehicle clubs where the students get involved in designing new vehicle technologies.
Well, the partnerships with agencies and industry is very important, but in my day, it was only the grad students who really had exposure to that. Does this affect an undergraduate education at Mac or U of A?
Absolutely.
In a really big way. For example, we have a very strong Engineers Without Borders chapter. Those young people are not only interested in thinking about how engineering can impact the developing world and new initiatives related specifically to development, but they're actually starting to push us around concepts of global engineering. And we're starting now to develop our programs in such a way that we're training our students how to engage in the major problems that face our society in the future related to water, energy, what have you.
At U of A, if I were an engineering student there, would I have access to NASA research as an undergrad, or is this something that's held off for the docs and the postdocs?
So, let me describe the kind of space research program at the University of Alberta. So we have a new space institute that's formed, the Institute for Space Science. Basically, it spans two faculties, the faculties of science and engineering. And from our perspective, it's really key for those two players to come together in order for us to make creative endeavors in space exploration. If you want to make an experiment in space, you have to design that experiment scientifically. But then you need to be able to build it, make sure it survives the launch, survives the space environment, and basically engineer it to operate instead of just, you know, you spend the money to launch it and then it dies. And so we have a program that actively involves undergraduates as well as graduate students. Let me, you know, talk a little bit about the undergraduate experience. There's a competition coming up that University of Alberta students are engaging in right now. It's called the Canadian Satellite Design Challenge. And so this is essentially an engineering as well as a science competition that allows undergraduate teams to literally design, go through the design reviews, and then build and hopefully launch ultimately a satellite, a small satellite, 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters, and to get the thing up there in space, literally a university satellite. There's other universities involved around the country. Now, that is a fantastic innovator, in my opinion, an opportunity for students to get right involved in all of the elements of space research and technology, and those people that get involved in that program are going to be very attractive for employment in the space industries in Canada that are out there. So we think this is an opportunity for real excellence and innovation in the undergraduate program.
Sounds promising. What's the motion simulator that I've heard about at Mac?
Well, we have a simulator that is built by CAE that provides builds simulators for the aerospace industry. It allows students great partner for us. It allows students, that's housed in our computing and software department. So in this case, the students are able to actually...
They're getting in it now, I think.
Oh, there you go. They're able to actually program this device and look at different ways of doing, for example, crash simulations or vehicle avoidance simulations. We just had an announcement this week with General Motors of Canada and IBM for a new research program focused on... software for the automotive technology, and as part of that announcement, we actually had students showing off their projects where they were showing a collision avoidance using software and built-in sensors. In this case, in model cars, but the same technology is what you would apply.
Undergrads are doing this.
These are undergraduate students, absolutely, yes.
Okay, the program, for instance, in space engineering or aeronautics, you don't have to go to Caltech or MIT to learn it. Do you have to go to the States, though, to get a job?
No, I mean, let's talk again about the state of Canadian aerospace industry. Canada has a very long heritage in space. So I'm going to keep talking about space as that example. But Canada was the third nation in space.
Yeah.
That's a not oft quoted fact. Canada also has the fourth largest aerospace industry anywhere in the world, after the U.S., France and Germany, I believe. So the fourth largest in the world. So there's an opportunity for employment with Canadian companies, people who've been trained in Canadian universities with these fantastic experiential learning. They can go into this particular business. And these companies are looking for qualified, innovative scientists and engineers to employ in their programs. And so there's a place for these people to go, and they can make a contribution to our economy. I think that's really important.
You know, Michael, that's a really good example of how both science and engineering graduates from Canadian universities engage in global industry.
Yeah.
Canada is the fourth largest exporter of engineering services in the world. So we have all sorts of companies that are based here in Canada, but whose expertise is being used to build plans, to run operations, and to develop technologies that are being used all over the world. So we talk about global engineering as a concept. We really mean our graduates are going to be working almost anywhere that you can find industry around the globe.
That's great. Great stories from engineering science from Mac and U of A. Thank you, gentlemen, for your time. Don't go away. We're back with science and technology after this short break.